The economic slowdown's continued much faster than expected, with exports and manufacturing falling. GDP figures out today show a 0.3% drop in the September quarter, and revised figures from earlier in the year mean we were in a recession and another could be on the way. Business correspondent Katie Bradford looks at what that means for balancing budgets in the workplace and at home.
Seeking help to get out of $40,000 of debt and chase her dreams.
I want to be a homeowner one day, and so in order for me to do that, I need to clear all the debts that I have at the moment and every other obstacle.
This company bought that debt and allowed the mum of four to pay the loan off interest-free, even contributing as little as $10 a week.
We've been able to afford food and be able to pay for the gas with petrol going up significantly.
As the economy stutters and slows, more Kiwis are reducing repayments.
Because at the moment, a lot of people are deciding, where do they spend their disposable income? And there's bills that do have to be paid, food, rent, etc.
Falling exports and manufacturing are what's hurting the economy, and high inflation's hurting everyone.
We've also got China not coming back into the market as hard and as fast as everyone would have liked or expected, and China's our biggest export market.
So as businesses also find themselves in the red, calls for help have reached record levels.
They're 50% higher than they were this time last year. That's roughly 120 businesses a month, 30 a week, calling us about getting information or advice on how to restructure the business or how to make people redundant.
One of the businesses that couldn't survive was online grocer Soupy. Suppliers devastated to be told today that because the liquidator removed fridges, perishable goods were left to rot and ruin.
I would really hope that at this time of year, especially if there are suppliers that have product on site that can be eaten, that are non-perishable, that they might consider donating them to a food bank.
The first bill passed by the government returned the Reserve Bank's sole focus to inflation, removing unemployment from its mandate.
We have to get inflation under control, and that means the Reserve Bank needs to be singularly focused on getting it down.
That's rubbish. Actually, all it does is mean that at some point in the future, when the Reserve Bank needs to be thinking about whether Kiwis are in jobs, it won't be part of their mandate.
For those doing their best to help themselves despite those economic pressures,
I'm also teaching the next generation how to handle money and how to not get into debt and to stay out of debt.
Lessons learnt the hard way.
And Katie's with us now live. So StatsNZ have effectively flip-flopped on whether we were in a recession.
Well, turns out if it looks like a recession, feels like a recession, probably is a recession. StatsNZ often goes away and revises its data. They've gone back over the year and most of the data has changed and been a bit worse than we thought. Look, the numbers are marginal there. There's been a lot of yo-yoing this year between going into positive and negative territory. But as you heard in that story there, exporters, businesses, people in general are feeling it tough. It's possible we may go back into recession again, and that's what people are feeling out there.
And the real world question right now, of course, what does all this mean for interest rates?
Well, that's what people always want to No, and it's a bit of a double-edged sword. It looks like, look, no one predicted this to be as bad as it was. It looks like the economy is slowing faster than Reserve Bank and others predicted. That means the Reserve Bank is probably doing its job. By increasing interest rates, it's actually working. But that means that interest rates may start going down a bit faster than people thought. Good news if you're a homeowner and got a big mortgage that you're trying to pay off. But what that means is not good news. Unemployment will keep going up. Businesses will keep going under. People will keep going into debt, probably another recession. It looks like from everyone I'm talking to, it's probably a tough 6 months ahead. Mm. I know that's not great festive cheer. I'm sorry.
Oh, kia ora, Katie. Thanks for the analysis, though.